One of the country's most remote settlements is also one of New Zealand's least vaccinated. Karamea is 100 kilometres north of Westport, and around 30% of its residents remain unvaccinated. That means the traffic light restrictions will have significant impact on daily life in Karamea. Here's Whena Owen.
I came for more freedom, and now we have this. It's unbelievable. It's unbelievable.
Karamea, 650 people living between the rainforest and the beach.
So there's just a total range of people, and because we're a small community, 100 kilometres up a dead-end road, you get to know a lot of those people.
The Karamea district has always attracted alternative communities, those wanting to build their own utopia. As far back as the 1880s, a group of close brethren set up in this valley and called it the Promised Land.
Peace in the valley.
Mike and Gisela, who came here 23 years ago from Germany to live off the grid, insist that peace has been well and truly shattered. For the last 12 years, Gisela, who's not vaccinated, has worked here at the last resort.
So what's going to happen for you next week?
Well, I can't work.
And from Friday, the unvaccinated can't enter the few cafes and bars where the community socialises.
If that is our only way to live, then I guess that's what we have to do.
Could you explain what do you mean, what you have to do?
Well, just like meet with some other people for a coffee somewhere or in someone's garden or wherever, so we can have a little bit of social life.
Because you can't come here, of course.
I can't come here, no.
I don't want to be policing my community.
Maggie Seaman is the owner-manager of The Last Resort.
The Last Resort is an icon in Karamea, and it's a community hub. And the people that work here also come here and socialise in the evenings, or they come with their children to the cafe. The children come here and play in the gardens.
The Last Resort is the town's biggest employer. Around a third of the staff will lose their jobs next week because they're unvaccinated. Lee has only a few more shifts before finishing up.
Once things start shutting down and people have to stay at home, there's not much life going on.
She's mum of preschoolers, and the only play centre in 100 kilometres is here in Karamea. It's temporarily closed because many of the parents supervising the children are not vaccinated. Around town, the new COVID regulations are testing friendships.
The majority always rule. The majority are vaccinated, so bit by bit they'll become a minority. But how hard that road's going to be in the meantime for them, well, time will tell.
Stephanie, a local unvaccinated mum, is convinced that road will be hard. The family are moving further out of town into the bush.
We want to first and foremost feel safe. And the second is that
what do you mean safe, Stephanie?
Just with the uncertainty with what's going on, with the world in general.
The mandate has meant Stephanie had to leave her job at the school and her part-time waitress job.
I do literacy at the school. I'm like the main literacy person. And there are students right there now that have no literacy program because I've left.
So did you feel the weight of that? I mean,
I did.
A lot of people watching this would say, look, why don't you just save yourself the stress and go and get vaccinated? And also the disappointment among the children, you know?
Well, I felt and still feel like I have abandoned them. Every day I kind of grapple with that.
She tells us she doesn't want the jab because of a medical condition, and the stress has taken its toll.
We could go to this dark place and feel like we're being controlled and like we're very restricted in our movements, or we can use our very creative minds to come up with ways to see a future within this framework.
Unvaccinated people are completely shut out from society, We have to create a new way of living.
Whether it's bringing back more of the bartering or having markets every day, having delivery services, looking after each other's children and doing homeschooling.
In the bush behind Karamea, we meet a local who has chosen not to be vaccinated or named and is preparing for a different society.
In a sense, this separatism we're setting up is going to create two economies. Two economies, you think about it.
So now he's working toward more self-sufficiency.
So that if there are refugees, I can feed them. Refugees, people that are being persecuted because they've made the choice to say no.
What life will be like for residents of Karamea who've decided not to be vaccinated will become clearer over the next few weeks.
I can imagine, yeah, we just have to stick to ourselves and, mind our own business, basically, and socialise together, yes, if they let us.